In this video, I'm going to automate some of the operations in this website. So the operations I'm going to automate, first of all I'm going to explain those operations. In the first stage, I will log in by this user ID and by this password, and then I'll click sign on. When I will be signed on, I'll click sign out. So basically, in the first test cases, I will just automate the signing and sign out process. In the second test case, I will sign in again. And after signed in, I'll click on accounts and I'll click on new account button. I will input data on the fields. I will populate all of the related data and then I'll click. So when I'll click save, the data I have input in those fields will be saved, and the account will be available. When I click on the account will be available here. And then when all of the operations are done, I will click sign out. In the third test case, again I will sign in. I'll click on accounts. I'll click on new account. I'll not input any data on any of the fields. I'll click on save button. The pop-up will appear. I'll read the message from the pop-up and then I'll close the pop-up and then I'll close the test. So three of the test cases will be automated, and those test cases will be automated by Selenium Java code. Besides this, I'll create a client server architecture. I have in the base machine, I have Windows 7 operating system, and I have some more operating systems in my virtual machine. So in my virtual machine, I have Windows Vista, Windows XP, and Ubuntu. So I will run these three test cases parallelly in both of the Windows 7 and Windows Vista. So for this purpose, I will use the XML configuration. The process is described. Now, so first of all, I created my test cases. Here, I have these three test cases. So I defined the priority by this declaration, and then I have first test cases do login, second test cases do login and create account, and the last test cases is login and without inputting any data, click on save, and then reading the pop-up message from the pop-up. So this is the three test cases. I'll give a brief description of my code. So in the first test case, just it will perform the login operation. It will use the user ID and password. It will click on sign in and then it will sign out. So this is the basic operation in first test cases. In the second test cases, second test case, I have what I did is I have I would like to explain a couple of lines of code from this here. I have, when I am generating the account number, I have used, I have generated a random account, random partial account number by this line of code, and after that I have added this random number with the test account string. So after that, when a user click on create account, when he actually clicks on this button, a new pop-up window appears from that. So what I did, when that pop-up window appears, before that I just read the window handle for the base window, that is this Yahoo.com Yahoo CRM create account. So I store that pop-up in a variable called called this variable. I store this pop-up in this variable, and after that, when the other pop-up appears with the accounts to be select, like when this pop-up appears, I read all of the window handles that currently open. So after that, what I did is I just got down all of the window handles in S1. So I just iterate those pop-up handles, and when I have applied the logic here like that, I compare all of the pop-up handles with the existing with the main window handle. So when, like in this line of code, the main logic has been implemented. So when pop-up handle is not main window handle, that means when the window handler is the pop-up window handler, then I move control to the switch to button, to the switch to I use switch to operation to transfer control to the pop-up handle. So in that way, I perform that pop-up operation, and after that, when I performed all of the operation, I just logged out. So in the final test cases, I have just read data from another alert, and I compare the data with this metric. So that is the operation that I did, and I have my configuration file here. My configuration file is up there, this one. So in that one, I have one test suit, that is suit one. In that test suit, I have two parallel tests. One of the tests is running on the base Windows 7 machine, this one, and the other test is running parallelly on Windows Vista. So for this one, when I am running my program, actually I am driving my test cases by this XML file, XML configuration file, and I am passing a parameter name browser, and I for Windows Vista, I ran my Firefox test on Windows Vista. I named my variable like that and called the test cases class of test cases. When I am running my test on Windows 7, I am running them on Chrome browser. So I defined again browser and put value as Chrome. So I have another classes here. This classes actually is I'm deciding which browser will be used in these cases. Like I have defined a switch case operation, and I'm getting a parameter as a Chrome. Then I am running my test on the base machine, and I have my Chrome driver in my C drive in the Selenium self server folder. I have my Chrome driver here, and I have my Selenium server standalone. Another library, Java library here that I have used. I'll show a little bit later. So I have my and when I am getting parameter as a remote node Firefox Vista, then what I did, I have defined the node as HTTP as that IP, and I have defined that capability. And by this capability and by this platform, I have called the and defined a remote driver. So by that way, actually I have initialized my driver. So to set up the client server architecture, what I did is first of all I go to the base machine, like I use command prompt, and in base machine what I did is I went to my root directory, and after that I go to the corresponding folder where I have the Selenium server file. So in that way, then I wrote the command, this command, and I define the role of this machine as when I press enter. When I press enter, as I so when I press enter, I got this message. So I'll not press enter as I already have configured my hub in this base machine. So let me show you this one. So when I wrote this command, Java jar Selenium server standalone, I got this window. And whether I have set it properly, I can justify that one by writing here. Writing here this one, localhost, and then by this command. So when I set up my server, when I set up my hub properly, then I am getting this window. This window, can you see that configuration and web driver and Chrome and Firefox browser icons? So those browser icons will not appear. It will appear just on top of the configurations thing. So in that way I have set up my hub that is actually working as a server, and in my virtual machine I have my node actually that is working as a client. So what I did is I open my command prompt, and after that I went to my root directory, and I go to my server folder where I store the corresponding file. Then I write the following command: Java jar Selenium server standalone 2.35 .0.0, it is the version of my Selenium server. So you can get that one from, if you go to Google and write that name, you'll get that library from the corresponding website. So after that, what I did is I did here what I did, which one will be the hub. So I set up my hub in that way here, like that way. Then I click on change advanced settings. Actually what we did is I click on change adapter settings, and after that I right click on this ring wireless network connection, and after that I click on this internet protocol version 4 on that one, and after that I select use the following IP address. So I got this IP address from command prompt by typing ipconfig, and I just use the default gate, same default gateway for client and server. And so this is the address of the hub. So the client will use this IP address as its hub or server. So as I have already done this, I will cancel this thing. So what I will write here, I'll use port 4 as so the client will read port 4 of the hub, and then I will use this to register and which port of the client. So now I'm defining the client port. So So when I type this command, I got these windows. So when I actually my command is on top, it's already gone as I run my program a couple of times. So when all of this command is typed and the client server setup is done, then if you just hover mouse on this one, you can see that 5 instances of Firefox you can run simultaneously in this client, and 5 instances of Chrome browser you can run simultaneously. So this is actually platform is Vista, browser name is Chrome. Okay. And you can see default proxy. This is actually the address of the client 192.168.130.5.56, and configuration of the so you can see the configuration of the client by this way. So if you want to see the configuration of the hub, then you can click on this one. You can see that port 4 is used as a communication port in node or say hub or server, and it has a IP of IP address is this one that I have used up there. So my server or hub has the IP of this one. my server has DJT and my client has So now I have given a brief description of my application. So I'm going to run my test cases right now. So I have used Eclipse IDE to edit my to write my code. So what I will do, I will click on run it and I will click run configuration. As I showed you, the test driver that is running my test is this XML file. So from Swift, I have like that. I have select the driver that will drive my test. I can select multiple driver and multiple test multiple driver can have multiple test cases at the same time. So one thing I would like to mention here that the configuration of my laptop is not that much higher. That's why test will run a little bit slowly. So I'm going to run my test. Right. So in the base machine, I've defined test to be run in Chrome browser. So it is running the test, and in the test has been started in this is Vista. Vista, and this is Vista. Test is running here. Test is running on Windows 7 at the same time parallelly. Okay. I will just minimize this one. And I'll keep focusing on this one on my base machine. You can see test is running on my virtual machine as well. Yep. This is my base machine. So as I was not doing my Windows properly, I'll run my test case one more time so that it runs as a let me have a look what I have on here. Yes, I got BD up there. Okay. And I got some Windows up there. Let me close this one. Now let me run the test case. Now I'll not touch. So you can see that from that console output test result window, I have six test cases. I have six test cases. Three of them I ran on Windows Vista, and three of them I ran on Windows 7. So failures is zero, skips is zero. So I can view the result in a little bit graphical way here. So like in my first in my test suite, I have one run in Windows 7. In Windows 7, I have three test cases, three of them passed. Each of them taken the time taken by each of the test cases is given here. And in my Windows Vista, I have three test cases, three same test cases, and it the time taken and their result status is shown here. The result status can be viewed like with more graphical data and more graphical test level statistics by when you click on right click on your project name and then refresh. Okay, when you click refresh, the test result is generated here. You click on test output. If you may see that index.html, click on that one. So up here we can get more graphical test results. Like I have two tests. One is Windows Vista, one is Windows 7. After that, I don't have any groups. I don't define any groups. Timing. We can see the time has been taken by each of the methods. By that way, we can see reporter output. Then we can see, I didn't define any reporter output. None of the test cases is ignored. Chronological view, you can have these more details in that way. So this is the overall test results, and I can have okay this test method been passed. So I'd like to mention here one thing. When you open the project, like you need to import the libraries. Like I import those libraries here. So if you click on right click on the project properties, Java build path. Yeah, you need to click external jars, and you need to first of all you need to download those Selenium libraries, Selenium 235 libraries. So inside that one you have slides. You need to select all of those libraries, and you need to have these two libraries. Besides that, you need one more library that is just you need to click on add library, test ng, and then click next. After that, when you start your project, you need to file new Java project, and after that, when you create classes, you need to click on your source folder, and after that, you need to click new, and after that, you need to click other, then you need to click test ng class. And for the XML file, you need to right click on your project name, and after that, sorry, you need to right click on your project name, and after that, you need to create a new and other, and then you need to create XML file to this driver XML file. I lost my voice yesterday because I got cold. So that was what I was able to do by this short.